Greetings. All our videos have subtitles, so you can use them if you don't understand what I say. In this video, we will be talking about morphs and how you can create them yourself. Morph is when you can change the shape of your character in some specific way. You can find an example if you use a generic Genesis character and go to the shaping window. Here we see different morph presets, such as Bodybuilder, for example, which made the character look very different. Morphs also can be combined on top of one another, which allows for creating very unique characters pretty easily. But there are only several built-in morphs. So we will see how you can create a morph yourself. For this, you need to change the geometry of your figure. There are two main ways of how you do this. First is by using the special tool directly in the DAW Studio. The tool is Deformer and we need to add it to the character. For this, make sure to select the character and go to the Create menu, find New Deformer here. This has added Deformer objects to the character. You need to select the Deformer field object and place it over the part of the character that you want to change. I want to change the head, so I scale it down a lot and use Translate to place field over the head. I can see that the head is selected because vertices glow with colors. Closer they are to the center of the field, stronger would be the deformation. Redder colors mean that these vertices are close to the center, while yellow means that they are further. Now to make a deformation itself, you need to select the deformer object under the base. When you apply any deformations to this object, it affects everything inside the field. This does not influence the eyelashes and tear object, so I will delete those. Like this, you can create deformations of any kind. Just move, rotate or scale the deformer and create something unique. I don't want to spend a lot of time on this for the tutorial, so I will just make something simple. Scaled it a bit and it looks like some kind of unusual alien now. When this is done, we need to save these changes as a morph. For this, we will use a deform tool. To use it, you need to open a corresponding window from the window, panes menu. Here it is, we can dock it to the side, so it would be more comfortable. Now select the character and proceed to use this window. The only things that we need here are apply spawn morphs and delete apply deformers options. Deleting deformers is not required, but I don't need them anymore. Then press spawn morph and give it a name. It will ask whether you want to delete deformers. And it is done, no more deformers, but the shape is still deformed. Also, there is a morph section that appeared in the parameters window. Here we can find our custom created morphs. You can use the slider to control the strength of changes, same as with any other morph. By default, this slider can go beyond 100%. And also into negatives, which can be weird, and if you don't like it, just go to its parameter settings and enable the limits here. Now it can only be changed from 0% to 100%. Morph is here, but we are not done yet. If I add another character to the scene, you will see why. Notice that the newly added character does not have the morph section at all, while the previous figure still does. This is because right now the created morph is unique and connected only to the one specific figure that it was created on. Worry not though, as all you need to do to fix this is go to the file, Save As, support assets, morph asset. Here, make sure that the directory goes to my library and don't worry about vendor name if you don't plan to sell this. Find created morph amongst all the properties. It should not be difficult, as it is connected to the character itself. Seems that I need to add a vendor name too. It is done. You can see that the morph is still there. But now if I add another character again, we see that it also has the same morph this time. Here are both characters with the morph applied. As said already, this is not the only way you can create a custom morph. I will refresh the scene to show you another example. It is based on modeling morphs using any other 3D modeling software. I will be using Blender for this. It is another free 3D design program with huge modeling capabilities. And there is a special add-on for exporting DAW Studio objects to Blender. You can also use a regular export option for this, just export as a .obj. I will be using a DAWs to Blender bridge though, as it is much more convenient. Now we are in Blender. We won't need any of the default items, so I will delete them. Now I open the side panel to access the DAWs to Blender add-on and import the figure. If you don't have this, we have a video dedicated to explaining DAWs to Blender bridge on the channel. Character is imported. By default, it is in pose mode, but we don't need it. Also, we don't need all these bones visible, as we are not going to change them. Now I have this character available in Blender, I can edit him however I want. I can use regular vertex editing, proportional editing, or maybe sculpting. I have resolved to sculpting. This is the result. Looks very silly, but the goal here was to make the character look very different from the default shape. I have narrowed the waist, legs, and neck of the character, but made hands and shoulders look bigger. Now I can export it using the regular method in the .obj format. Here you select the save path, name of the object, and also important to limit the export to selection only and select the character. Back to the DAWs Studio. Here you would think that we need to import now whatever we made in Blender with a regular import button. But it is not like that, as we don't want to import a character that we made, but instead, we only need the changes. What we will use is the Morph Loader Pro from the Edit, Object menu. This is the tool to import morphs. Here you need to use the Choose Morph Files button and locate the .obj file you have exported from the Blender. It is not yet ready. Also, you need to change the converted geometry setting here on top. If you used regular .obj export and import, you then probably can use one of these presets. But as I have used a DAWs to Blender bridge, it does not work for me. Instead, I need to manually change these settings.
The scale should be 10,000% and axis should be X, Y, and Z in that order,
as you see on the screen. Then click Accept. You will see the new morph appear in the Morphs section. And it works exactly as it should. It again can go into negatives, which looks quite scary. Same as last time, you can fix that in the parameter settings. When using this method, you also need to save the morphs as morph support asset, or it would not be available for characters other than this. I have now both morphs available for all Genesis 8.1 male figures and even can use them simultaneously. Creating morphs yourself can be very difficult, as you need to have some modeling skills for that. Gladly, on the DAWS 3D marketplace, there are plenty of items that will help us with these problems. For example, Genesis 8 female body morphs made by DAWS. It proposes quite a few different shapes for your female Genesis figures. An absolutely different variant is aging morphs for Genesis 8 male. It allows you to age your figures, which is awesome. As there is no way to do something like this by default in DAWS Studio. It can be a very useful morph, that allows for some unique outcomes. On the other hand, there is Growing Up by the same artist. It also allows you to change the age of the character, but instead of adding features of the old people, it can make characters younger or create adults from the children. Last for today is Phenotype Shape and Pose Bundle for Genesis 8. This bundle includes some special morphs that you won't see anywhere else. These morphs allow for creating very distinctive and memorable characters. Also recommend you to visit our website, renderguide.com, where you can find articles on the different topics for both DAWS Studio and Blender. This includes the DAWS 3D Create Custom Morph tutorial that has even more information on the current theme.
Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to get more inspiration. Thank you.